everyone. Welcome back to another video. Thanks for tuning in. Today I'm doing the kitchen organization tag, which was created by hosted by Chrissy. Her link is in the description box. I thought it was a great tag. I really like the questions and I'm sharing my answers here. If you're interested in these types of videos relating to your home, including organization, decor, any DIY projects, maybe some cleaning videos or any reviews, please do hit the subscribe button because those are the types of videos that I make. If you're interested in my kitchen organization, please stay tuned. All right, so the questions, and there's 10 questions. The first question is, do you have a pantry? And if so, how often do you clean or organize it? We don't actually have a full pantry. We do have this cabinet where we keep a lot of our food items. It acts as a pantry. So we keep our cereals in there, some other little snacks, chips, and things like that at the top part. And then at the bottom, we have some small appliances and a few other little odds and ends. So that's our main pantry-like cabinet storage space. And then we also have space under the island. The racks slide out and you can place things in there, so we have that. We also have a space in the cabinet area that acts as storage for canned goods and other such items. As far as cleaning and organizing these things, I try to keep them pretty much cleaned and organized when we buy more groceries. Do you store paper goods in your kitchen? So paper plates, napkins, paper towels. We do store paper plates and plastic cups in the cabinet, and we'll just keep those up there. And then we do store the napkins in the pantry cabinet, and then paper towels are stored in a storage closet, so not in the kitchen. Number three, do you prefer glass, plastic, or original food containers to store food in your pantry or cupboard? The only things I normally take out of the original packaging is sugar and flour. So for those, I have these mason jars, and I do prefer the mason jars if I'm gonna store anything outside of its normal packaging. Number four, do you have a command center or space, a message board, key drop, calendar, etc.? We do have a message board. It's a chalkboard organizer type of thing. So we write down things that we need to buy mostly. And then there's a space on the bottom where we just hold some pens and a little notebook. And then I also have a little air freshener in there and a flashlight. We do have a key rack where we hang our keys. We do keep a calendar on the opposite side of the wall from the chalkboard. Number five, how do you store your takeout menus? For our takeout menus, I keep them in the back of my recipe book. So I have a binder, and in the back of the binder in the little pocket is where we keep our menus. We usually order the same things over and over, but we do keep the menus there just in case we want to switch it up. Do you have a junk drawer? There's a couple of junk drawers. They've been cleaned a few times, but they just seem to collect and collect. So I try to put these little cups in there to organize those, but it usually just turns into a junk drawer. How often do you purge your kitchen gadgets? Your manual can opener, non-electric, etc. When it breaks or when it gets dirty. So I just got rid of the blades for my electric blender because they started to rust. I had to get rid of those. I had a peeler that recently broke, so I purchased another peeler. So basically when things start failing or start to tarnish, that's when we'll just get rid of things and get something else. Number eight, how do you store your spices, cabinet, drawer, etc.? I keep the like spices together, so those are on this little mini rack next to the stove. And in this cabinet right above those spices is where we keep others that are too large to put on the rack, and also some for more like for baking. So that those are stored right above, and they're not in any kind of order, it's just in there. Number nine, how do you store your leftover food storage containers, like Tupperware and plastic containers? Our plastic containers are Rubbermaid mostly, and they're kept in the cabinet. Containers on the right hand side, and then a bigger container actually holds the lids to the containers on the right. And number 10, do you prefer to store your small appliances on your countertop or elsewhere? We have this little sliding door that hides some of our appliances. So in there is where we keep our toaster, and there's an outlet in the back. So the toaster stays plugged in. We just slide it out, use it, let it cool down, and then push it back in and close the door. And also in that cabinet is the Nutribullet and a blender. And then the Nutribullet cups and everything is all in there as well. Other small appliances are kept underneath the counter in this corner cabinet. That's where I have a chopper. It minces things and chops things up, and that's kept under there. The rice cooker is under there, and also my electric blender. Once again, in the cabinet pantry cupboard is where we keep other small appliances as well. There's an omelet maker in there, a waffle maker, a coffee pot. That is the old school coffee pot. We have a Keurig, but my husband didn't want to get rid of the original coffee pot. A crock pot is under there, and a rolling pin. So that is my list. That is how I keep my kitchen. There's a lot of other things going on in the kitchen too, but those are the answers to these questions here. Thanks, Chrissy, for creating the tag and leaving an open invitation for anyone to do it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.